A world-renowned event is returning to Sharon in Mercer County this weekend. It's called Waterfire. It's a dramatic scene at nightfall. Torchbearers set 50 massive floating braziers ablaze on the Shenango River. People line the banks to watch the spectacle while music is playing to set the scene. Only a handful of cities around the world have Waterfire events in their towns, and we are so lucky to have it in Sharon, not far from downtown Pittsburgh, just a little over an hour. And here with more on Waterfire this Saturday night is Karen Anderson. Thanks so much for coming.
Thank you for having us. Thank you.
This is neat. I've never been to this event, but it's so cool that we have one of the only places, you know, in the world that does something like this.
Yes, we're kicking off our fifth season this year. Our first event is tomorrow. We start at noon. Everything opens at noon. And we have artists and food vendors that will be there. And we have three stages with music. And then at dusk, we light the braziers on fire everything kicks off.
Now, does anything else float down the river while the braziers are lit?
We do. We have a ceremony. It starts around dusk with the blessing of the river. Native American Leon Briggs blesses the river for us. And then we have the ceremonial lighting. And then kayaks go down the river. And with the theme being honoring your ancestry, the kayaks are going to have flags from different countries all around the world on them. And then we also have entertainers that are going to be coming down the river singing. So,
can you tell me about Waterfire and its roots? How did it start?
In Providence, Rhode Island, is where Waterfire started. Barnaby Evans is the founder of Waterfire, and he was in a community where there's a beautiful river, just like in Sharon, and decided we should do something to bring people in to enjoy the river, and that's how it came. Gary Mazaris was one of the people that brought Waterfire to Sharon. He and a small group of people had been in Providence and saw it and thought, why not bring this to Sharon? And what it's become is, it's not just a downtown Sharon event, it is a regional event. We have people that come in from all across the country to enjoy Waterfire.
It's so amazing looking at the images. Is this from last year? Just beautiful. Is there anything, you know, can rain stop the event from happening? And luckily, it looks like we're going to have good weather.
But, well, right now, we're really hoping that the rain stops, because the height of the river can cause us a little bit of a challenge. So right now, we're in good shape. So we're going to hope that the weather cooperates with us. And so the event is free and open to the public, and it's pet friendly as well. So bring your pets. There's a lot of parking available for people to come in, and we also have a handicap section for them.
So you mentioned that there's a blessing of the river. Does that tie into any of the traditions with Waterfire?
Yeah, that was a tradition that was started in Providence, and we carried on down here. So we also, during the day, because a lot of people think that things don't really kick off until the evening, but during the day we have a lot of activities.
Oh, great.
Including a large children's activity area. And this year, to tie into the theme, our friends at Hermitage Home Depot are giving us the supplies to make small boats, so the children will be able to make small boats that they can take home. And again, it ties into the theme, your ancestors came over on the boats. So we'll be making ornaments, and there's all kinds of activities.
And do you have fireworks or just fire performers?
Just fire performers.
Okay.
Jimmy Pyro will be there, and we also have an aerialist going to be there. Ziska out of Cleveland, Ohio will be there, and her first performance will be at 3 o'clock. She's actually going to be right on the bridge, so she'll be tied into the opening festivities on the river as well.
And so you mentioned there will be stages and performers throughout the day?
Correct. Yeah, starting about 1 o'clock. We have three stages spread throughout the venue so that people can enjoy different types of music, and that ties again into the theme. We have the tamboritzas, we have Chardon polka bands, so we try to bring everything together. We're also going to have some places around where people can mark on maps, world maps, where their ancestors came from.
So very involved.
Mm-hmm.
You had 70,000 people the first year that you did this. How many are you expecting
this year?
That
first year was quite a kickoff.
Yeah.
And so we usually have about 15,000 to 20,000 people, and that's our expectation. Getting around town is fairly easy. We have, like I said, we have ample parking.
Great.
And there's a lot of directional and a lot of volunteers. That's the one thing that we do rely on, our
volunteers.
It takes about 350 people to do a Waterfire.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for being here and telling us about that. The first Waterfire Sharon of the season is this Saturday, July 15th. Then there are two others to complete the season on August 19th and September 23rd. You can get all the details and the full schedule of events and bands at kdka.com/PTL. We have it posted for you there.